What an idyllic scene of nature. The plants are soaking up the rays of the sun. Fertilised crops are growing tall in the fields. An array of solar cells is churning out clean energy. It can only mean one thing. That's right, quantum mechanics in action. Single photons of light that have travelled through space are converted into energy by plants using a complex series of reactions in protein molecules. Solar cells use these photons to excite electrons in carefully designed materials to generate electricity. We need fertilizer molecules to feed half the world's population, but the best methods we know to produce them are inefficient and use 1% of global energy production. If we could use computer simulations to accurately model these processes, we could design even better solar cells, fertilizers, batteries, or even drugs. But getting computers to model quantum mechanical objects is a tough ask. A model with just 40 atoms would hoover up more computing memory than there is on the planet. Richard Feynman realized all this back in the 1980s. He said, "If you want to build a simulation of nature, you'd better make it quantum mechanical." In other words, you need a completely new type of computer, a quantum computer, built using the laws of quantum mechanics. Feynman also said, "By golly, it's a wonderful problem, because it doesn't look so easy." He was right, but we're working on it, and it could change the world.